perpetual motion machine. And it features a lot of, in what Sanskrit is called vinyasa. Vinyasa means movement, which is led by the breath. So it's a lot of deep breathing, and the movements follow the breathing. That happens during sun salutation A's, some abdominal work, some leg strength exercises, as well as borrowing from my teacher, Max Strom, and from the Bihar-style as well. So the only thing you'll need this week is, besides your mat, if you have one, is a block for balance and engagement purposes. And so let's begin. So let's lie on the back. So lie face up and feet flat on the floor. And as you inhale, you're gonna breathe into belly, arch your back, and that's inhale. So this is our first vinyasa. That's your in-breath, and then exhale, draw your navel down, press your low back down. And try that a couple times. Inhale, you extend your spine, press tip of tailbone into floor, breathe into belly, and then exhale, press your low back into the floor, tailbone slides forward, and draw your navel in. So as we connect to low back here, we're linking breath, movement, and attention. That's the fullest expression of vinyasa, breath, movement, attention. So another few breaths here. Arching your spine on inhale, pressing your low back down on exhale. And then notice the waves of movement up your spine. You'll feel your head rocking a little bit back and forth. Okay. So keep on doing what you're doing with your low back. You're gonna take your hands underneath your head and inhale. As you arch your back, we're gonna add looking at the wall behind you. So this is extension of your neck as well. Exhale, as you press your low back into the floor, pick your head and shoulders up off the floor. And then you inhale, place your head down, arch your spine, look behind you. That's your breath in. Exhale. Navel toward the floor, low back in the floor, and lift your head and shoulders. So this is basically a slow, thoughtful version of the classic crunch. So do this a few times as we're warming up our abdomen, warming up the rest of our spine all the way from sacrum to skull. Notice what you can notice and have your breath be the conductor. Okay? Now as you pick up your head and lay it back down, we're gonna add an arm practice to this. As you inhale, look back, press your elbows into the floor, and as you exhale, you're gonna press your low back into the floor, elbows come together in front of your face. So that's in addition to the low back movement that we're doing, to the neck work that we're doing. We're now getting some shoulder blade and some shoulder joint movement here. Inhale, elbows press down. You can squeeze your shoulder blades in. Exhale, elbows come together, and that wings your shoulder blades out. So inhale, retract shoulder blades. Exhale, protract shoulder blades. So your elbows are opening and closing like a pair of butterfly wings. They're open on inhale. Butterfly wings close on exhale. The last thing we're going to add is to have your knees mimic your elbows. So now it's like two pairs of butterfly wings. Inhale, elbows and knees toward the floor. Exhale, pin your elbows and knees together. And you try that several more times. So we're warming up shoulders, warming up hips, warming up spine, and all being conducted by your breath. Last time here, take a deep breath in, draw your navel in, lift your head, exhale, and then from there, lie on the floor and pause. Notice what you can notice. All right, and then from here, you're gonna press your low back into the floor, and please step your right ankle on top of your left thigh, okay? The foot that's on the floor, your left foot, bring it in toward the center, toward the midline. So we're gonna press that foot down into the floor. And as you inhale, you're going to peel your spine up off the floor to try to come up into a one-legged bridge. So how high you go, that's up to you. There's no requirement. And then as you exhale, lower down. And try that a few times. So you press your left foot down, press your hips up, and then exhale, lower down. And the breath leads the way. Inhale up into this one-legged bridge. Exhale, lower. Head remains relaxed. Arms remain relaxed, even as your lower body and your torso are doing some good work. So one more time here. Inhale up in the bridge. And then exhale down. Continue exhaling. And with the power of your left leg, draw the whole ensemble in as tightly as you can. And then inhale, place your left foot on the floor, lift into bridge. Exhale, lower down, press your low back into floor as you draw the whole ensemble in. So you're squeezing your legs in as tightly as you can. Now it's going to give you a stretch on the outside of your right leg, perhaps. That's what we're going for. And go back and forth like this. The pacing of your breath is up to you for this entire practice. If you need to go a little faster or slower than I am, go ahead. Just keep the breath in the forefront of your mind. And keep it deep, steady, and leading the way. So let's try this twice more. Inhale up into your one-legged bridge. Exhale down, and if it feels okay, hug it all, draw it all in, hands free. And left foot on the floor, hips press up toward the ceiling. And exhale, lower down, draw it in with the power of your left leg. And then from there, place both feet on the floor. All right. So notice the warmth we've gathered so far. Take a deep breath in. And big exhale. So now please, left ankle on top of right thigh. You can move your right foot into the middle. You pause here. Take a deep breath in. And big exhale. Find your foot connected into the floor. And then peel your spine up off the floor. Lift into your one-legged bridge. On top of the inhales, the top of your breath, and then exhale, lower down. And repeat just that first move a few times. So foot connects in the floor, hips press up toward the ceiling, you breathe into that whole expansion, and then exhale as you lower, you exhale. So inhale, deep breath in, lift, and exhale. Lower. Notice if this side feels a little bit more wobbly than the first side, or if this feels more engaged and intuitive. All right, and so you can always stick with that if you'd like. Inhale, your hips are lifting up. Exhale, come down. With the power of your right leg, draw the whole thing in. Squeeze it. And then inhale, foot on floor, lift up into bridge. Top of the inhales, top of the breath. Exhale, you lower and draw the whole ensemble in with the power of your right leg. And go back and forth like this several times. So as you use your right leg to draw the left leg in, you're going to notice the stretch on outer left hip. All right, if you're doing a substantial amount of work, you might feel your arms or your face get involved with this. Other than being a conduit for the breath, face is relaxed. The eyes are soft, even though the breath is very voluminous and strong. Okay, very good. So as you exhale, draw the whole thing in. And then inhale, right foot on the floor, left foot on the floor, and extend your legs forward. Take your arms in goalpost position. That means by your sides with your elbows bent, back of hands onto floor. And every exhale will relax to this spot. As you inhale, reach one arm behind you and press the same side heel forward. And breathe into the side that you're stretching. As you exhale, recoil your arm, relax your leg. And then we'll try that on the other side. Reach your other arm back, same side heel forward. You breathe into the stretch and exhale, recoil and relax. And go back and forth like this a couple times. Again, breath leads the way. As you press your heel forward, you'll feel calf stretch, perhaps hamstring stretch. As you reach your arm back, you're gonna feel shoulder stretch, side ribs perhaps. Kind of notice what you can notice. Have the breath lead the way. Breath is the conductor. And let's do that another few times. So you started on one side, you cycle through to the second side, deep breath into your second side, and then after that's done, you can release and relax, place your feet flat on the floor again, arms out in wingspan at this point, so straight out to your sides. All right, and pause there, notice what you can notice, and from here, you're gonna step your feet together, knees together. And then please take your right thigh on top of your left. So you're crossing your legs as if you're in a narrow chair. And as you inhale, your knees are going to drop to the right. Your head's gonna turn to the left and reach your left fingers as far out to the left as you can. So this is a sort of twisting side stretch. You're also gonna arch your back a little here on in-breath. And then exhale, recoil and relax. And repeat this same side several times. So knees to the right, head turns left, fingers reach out way deep, leading with your inhale, and then exhale recoils you back to center. And then you re-expand. Inhale. Deep breath into the side you're stretching. And exhale out of it, uncoil toward the ground. And let's try that twice more. Take a deep breath in. Fingers nice and wide, jazz hands. And exhale, you recoil and relax. And one last time on our left side here. Head turns to left. Look at the fingers as they slide outward. Exhale as you come back to center. Place your feet flat on the floor. Notice what you can notice. All right. Very nice. And then from here, please step your left foot on top of your right. Sorry, left thigh on top of your right. Cross your thighs as if you're sitting in a narrow chair. Every exhale, you're going to relax into this spot. And as you inhale, expand outward. The knees drop left. Head turns to the right. And slide your right fingers as far to the right as you can. You can also arch your back here a little. And that's on inhale. Exhale, recoil back to center. And then repeat this several times. Knees to the left. Head to the right. Fingers reach out, take a deep breath in, and then exhale, recoil, relax. And so try this several times. Does this side feel exactly the same as it did on the first? Knees and eyes in opposite directions? And if it doesn't feel as the same as it did on the first side, maybe you can notice some particulars. So maybe the arm feels like it can stretch more. Maybe your outer hip feels a little tighter, something like that. Some type of analysis. And inhale into the stretch, exhale into the uncoiling and releasing. Try this twice more. Take a deep breath in, and take a big exhale. And one last, take a deep breath in. Okay, very good. Place your feet flat on the floor. All right, notice the after effects of that movement. Yeah, take a deep inhale here, and then exhale. So we're going to flip over, lie face down. Okay, and this is sort of like an ekapada locust, a sort of one-armed and one-leg shalabhasana. You're going to take your right hand on top of your left hand, and then your forehead's gonna be on your hand. So the first thing that we're gonna do, and you can sort of look at this, I call it saluting. In this case, it's gonna be saluting to the right. So you draw your shoulder blade in, keep that drawn in, and then it's like you glued your hand to your forehead, and you're gonna peel your heart out to the right. Now the hip's gonna wanna lift, keep your hip down. So as you salute to the right, press your right hip down, and then exhale, come back to the floor. And try that on the same side again. Inhale, you salute to the right, and then exhale, come down. You can stay doing this, or if you'd like to lift the opposite leg, you can. So as you salute to the right, engage your left leg and try to lift your left thigh. So back cross-functional work. Then try this several times. Take a deep breath in. And exhale, come out of that. Yeah, and repeat this same thing several times as you squeeze the muscles of your back body, squeeze your glutes, your hamstrings. Your breath lifts you up, and your exhale relaxes you down. And try that twice more. Take a deep breath in, and exhale. One last time. So take a deep breath in, squeeze your shoulder blade in, inhale up, exhale, come back down. Pause here for a moment as you curl your toes under, press your heels back to traction both legs. So heels drive back, feel the traction in the back of both legs. All right, very good. You can point your toes back and pause your legs there for now. Switch your hands. So now your left hand's on top, and you're gonna glue your left hand to your forehead so it stays against your forehead the whole time. So saluting to the left, you're gonna draw your left shoulder in so your elbow comes up as high as you can. So that motion is included with the salute to the left. So you're gonna lift up, exhale, come back down, and try that again. Inhale, lift to your left. Your left hip's gonna wanna lift. Press your left hip down as you lift your heart. And that's on in-breath. Exhale as you come down. And if you'd like to, we're saluting to the left, so you lift your opposite leg. Right leg lifts. Exhale, you come back down. And repeat that several times. Take a deep breath in. And exhale. So this is back cross-functional line, essentially from one shoulder to the opposite, the back of the opposite leg. And so you try this several times. Take a deep breath in. Breathe into belly. Exhale, you come out of that. And repeat this several times at the pace of your breathing. Breath leads the way. Breath is conducting. And let's try that one more time. So let's take a deep breath in. Take a big exhale. And one last time. Take a deep breath in. Okay. Great. And then release. You can relax your head onto the ground. Curl your toes under. Press your heels back. And there's several breaths here. So you drive your heels back. Legs are engaged. The glutes can slide back as well. And two more breaths here. Take a big inhale. Big exhale. And one last time, breathe in. Okay, great. And then from here, you place your hands and feet on the floor. We're gonna come up to hands and knees. The next vinyasa is cat-cow. As you inhale, you're coming into the cow, so extension of your spine. Look up, that's your inhale. And then exhale, draw your navel in around your spine. And repeat this several times. So take a deep breath in. You squeeze the muscles of back body. I also squeeze my shoulder blades together. That helps drop the heart a little bit further down. And the shoulder blades protract, which helps lift your heart up toward the ceiling. And go back and forth like this several times. Deep breath in. Exhale brings you into cat. Inhale brings you into cow. So inhale, back body engages. Exhale, front body engages. And let's do this twice more. Take a deep breath in. Big exhale. And one last time. Take a deep breath in. Exhale. You can can take your knees closer together, and we're going to include your right leg in this in the cat-cow. So as you inhale, press your right heel back, open your toes, and as you exhale, point your toes and draw your knee up tightly. Then do that four more times. Take a deep breath in, drive your heel back, open your toes, exhale, point your toes, draw your knee in tightly. Three more times, breath in. Big exhale, draw your knee in. Inhale, extend your right leg, heel back. Exhale, point your toes, draw your knee in. And one last time, press your heel back. Exhale, draw your knee in, and then place that knee on the floor. Next inhale, left heel presses back. You can also arch your back, draw your shoulder blades in, all that good cat-cow work. Exhale, point your toes, draw your knee up tight. And four more times. Inhale, drive your heel back, squeeze your shoulder blades in. Exhale, point your toes, draw your knee up. Take a deep breath in, drive your heel back. And then exhale, leads your way with the knee drawing in around your spine. And let's do that one more time. Take a deep breath in, drive your heel back. And exhale, draw your knee in. Okay. Very good. So you can take a little bit of a break in your hands. Make a couple wrist circles. All right. Very good. Then from here, we're going to plant the hands. Take downward facing dog. And from downward facing dog, we're going to come into plank right away. So inhale. I always think of like my fingers are on a ledge. I'm going to look over the ledge on in-breath. And then I'm going to lift my thighs back into downward facing dog. So let's try that four more times. Inhale. You look over the ledge. Exhale, lift your upper thighs back. Inhale, look over the ledge. Exhale, upper thighs back. And let's do that twice more. Inhale, look over the ledge. Exhale, back into downward facing dog. And one last time, inhale, look over the ledge. Exhale, back into downward facing dog. So from here, step your feet together. Send your right leg back and up, so it's a one-legged dog. Take a deep breath in, drive your heel out, open toes, and then exhale, you point your toes, look over the ledge, and draw your knee up tight. And let's do that four more times. Inhale, drive your heel back, straight leg. Exhale, point your toes, draw your knee in. Three more times. Take a deep breath in. Big exhale, draw it in. Twice more, breath in, drive your heel back. Exhale, point your toes, draw your knee in. And one last time on your first side, take a deep breath in. Exhale, point your toes, draw your knee in, and then replace one foot with the other. Lift your left leg back nice and solid. Take a deep breath in, one-legged dog. Exhale, point your toes, draw your knee up tight, look over the ledge. Four more. Deep breath in, drive your heel back. Exhale, point your toes, draw your knee in. Three more times. Deep breath in, heel drives back. Exhale, point toes, knee in. Deep breath in, straight leg, bolt your heel back. Exhale, point your toes and draw your knee in. And one last time, and then we're off our hands. Deep breath in. And then exhale, draw your knee into chest. Come back down. Okay, and again, take a break with your wrists, a couple wrist circles. So all this breath work, kind of notice how it invigorates the body. It gets a little bit more heat going. Sometimes I call this work huff and puff because it does sort of feel like suspiciously like cardio. So, good. So we're gonna take hands to floor, one more variation. As you inhale, your right arm reaches, right heel presses back, opposite arm reaches forward. Okay, now you're gonna draw your left shoulder blade in, lift your right leg. This is sort of like the salute. And then as you exhale, round your spine and draw your knee and elbow toward one another. And try that four more times. Take a deep breath in, squeeze the muscles cross-functional in the back. Exhale, draw your navel in, cross-functional up front, elbow to knee. And three more times. Deep breath in. And exhale, elbow to knee, round your spine. Twice more, squeeze your shoulder blade in, extend your back leg. Exhale, draw elbow to knee. And one last time, take a deep breath in, back cross functional. Exhale, front cross functional, and then all four limbs on the floor. Let's switch sides. Left leg goes back, right arm reaches forward. You're gonna squeeze shoulder blade in and back bend, back leg straight. That's your in breath. Back cross functional. Exhale, draw your elbow and knee into one another. And let's try that four more times. Deep breath in, full extension of leg, extension of spine. Exhale, round your spine and draw your knee in. Take a deep breath in. Huge exhale, get all the air out. And twice more, take a deep breath in. Shoulder blade squeezes in. Exhale, draw your navel in. Let's do that one more time. Take a deep breath in. All right, and exhale, draw elbow to knee, knee to elbow. Great, and let's come around to seated. All right, so legs are out in Dandasana, and we're gonna hug your right knee into chest. So this is giving a good hug. You can round your spine here. This is a sort of a flexion of the spine. And then you hold your hamstring, press your heel out, draw your shoulder blades in and lift your lungs. Like it's almost a boat pose, Navasana on one side. That's your inhale. Exhale, draw your shin in. Inhale, arch your back, lift your lungs. Exhale, draw your shin in around your spine. Inhale, press your heel forward and up. Also draw your shoulder blades in. And one more time on this side. Exhale, draw it in. Inhale, press your heel up, and then release leg. Left knee hugs in now. The foot's off the floor. This is your rounding. So that's it on exhale. As you inhale, hand to hamstring, extend your leg, draw your shoulder blades in, and lift your lungs up. So this side is like it's in boat pose. Navasana. And then exhale, draw your knee in, round your spine. Take a deep breath in, exhale, knee in, round spine, and three more times. Extend your leg, extend your spine, expand your breath, exhale, collect everything. And deep breath in, and big exhale. And one last time, take a deep breath in. Okay, big exhale, hug that in. And release. Now, if that felt okay, if this next practice doesn't wind up working, just go ahead and do one leg at a time. But I'm gonna do 10 with both legs at the same time. So we're just sitting on our hips, okay? The feet are off the ground. You're hugging your knees in on exhale. Hold your hamstrings, draw your shoulder blades in, and press your heels up as high as you can. That's your in-breath. Exhale, draw the whole thing in. If this doesn't work, just do five single-leggeds on one side, five single-leggeds on the other. Exhale, draw one leg or both legs in. Take a deep breath in. Arch your back. Exhale, round your back. Take a deep breath in. Arch your back. Exhale, round your back. And we have five more. Inhale, arch your back. Press heels up. Exhale, round. Inhale, arch. Huge exhale, round and tuck in. Inhale, expand. Exhale, contract. Inhale, expand. Exhale, contract. And one more, take a deep breath in. And exhale, contract. Okay, great. And then from there, release into hands and knees. Let's step back into downward facing dog. All right. Nice, and just two more breaths here. So notice how the body's feeling now. Can you breathe deeply, like you've been doing, in a still posture? So the vinyasa can actually train you to separate the power of the breath with the movement of the pose. Sometimes our brains tend to link those two together. But even in the still pose, you can have very dynamic breathing. And then from here, step up toward the top of your mat. Maybe I'll step like two-thirds of the way up. And we'll take an uttanasana, forward fold. Now from here, the arms can dangle. So it's very much like gorilla arms. They're just kind of relaxed. But your shoulder blades are gonna squeeze in. and your lower back's gonna squeeze. So you come up. This is like cow, except where our hands aren't on anything. And then exhale, you relax and round. Inhale, squeeze the muscles of your back body. Exhale, you round your spine. And let's try that. Let's do it 5 more times. Inhale, squeeze. Exhale, release and round. Inhale, squeeze shoulders together. Squeeze your low back muscles. Exhale, round. And 3 more times. Take a deep breath in. And big exhale. And twice more. Breathe in. And take a huge exhale. And one last time. Take a deep breath in. Okay, very good. So you recruit those muscles and now come all the way up. Arms sweep up overhead. Glutes slide down. Lift your lungs. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, palms come through heart center and by your sides in standing pose, basic standing pose, mountain, Tadasana. All right, so we're finally up to standing. We are going to take a couple sun salutation A's to start. Inhale, you're going to reach your arms up. And you bend your knees a little bit. Exhale, forward fold. Now, I like to add that back bending in. So inhale, you're going to squeeze the muscles of your back body. And then exhale, plant your hands and step back in the plank position. Either here, lower halfway down, or all the way down. As you inhale next, you're going to lift up into cobra or upward facing dog. And then as you exhale, you can come through hands and knees if you need to, and lift into downward facing dog. And we'll just do 2 breaths here. So big inhale, big exhale, breath in. And then as you exhale, step up toward the front of the mat. I like to do that big back bend practice. You squeeze the muscles of your back body, come part way up. Exhale, you lower. And then let's come all the way up. Arms sweep up overhead. Palms come through heart center and by your sides. So that's a sun salutation A. We'll do that twice more. Take a deep breath in, arms overhead. You can bend your knees a little bit if you need to, and forward fold. We're gonna come up, squeeze the muscles of your back body. Deep breath in, you can look forward. And then plant your hands. Exhale, step back to plank and lower halfway down or all the way down. Tops of feet on the floor. Inhale, lift your lungs forward into cobra or upward facing dog. And then exhale, upper thighs into downward facing dog. And several breaths here. All right, so first time we did 2. Now let's do 4 or 5. Even though the pose is still, can you make the breath dynamic? Can the breath reflect how much energy your arms and legs are putting in? So maybe 1 more time here. Take a deep breath in. And then exhale, you can step or hop up toward the front of your mat. All right, with the feet on the ground, squeeze the muscles of your low back, squeeze shoulder blades together. Exhale, fold. And then come all the way up. Arms sweep up overhead. Exhale, palms through heart center and by your side. Let's do 1 more sun salutation A. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, forward fold. Let's do the extension practice. Inhale, shoulder blades squeeze in, low back squeezes in. Exhale, plant your hands, step or float back to plank. Lower halfway down or all the way down. Tops of feet on the floor. Inhale, back body engages. Shoulder blades slide away from your ears. And then exhale, lift into downward facing dog. This time, a few more breaths, so like 6 or 8 deep breaths here. And even though the pose is still, can you take titanic inhales, deep exhales, really open the shutters here, ventilate. Step up toward the top of your mat. From Uttanasana, come part way up. So you squeeze the muscles in your lower back, squeeze your shoulder blades. Exhale, you refold. And then let's come all the way up to standing. Arms sweep up overhead. And exhale, this concludes the sun A's. We'll be doing sun salutation B's now. They're more complicated, longer. They include a warrior one. But if you're familiar with them, you can sort of follow your own internal cues with this. But you're going to bend the knees. It starts out in chair, so you bend your knees, arms sweep up overhead. Take a huge inhale, squeeze your shoulder blades in, and then as you exhale, lift your sitting bones to forward fold. I like the rounding of the back, so inhale, look forward and up. Squeeze the muscles of your low back. Exhale, plant your hands, step back in the plank position. Lower halfway down or all the way down. Tops of feet on the floor. Inhale, squeeze your shoulder blades in into upward facing dog. And then exhale, we're gonna come back into downward facing dog. From here, right leg, you're gonna lift the right leg back and up. And then exhale, draw your right knee in and do whatever it takes to get your right foot forward. Your back leg's gonna plant, so turn your back toes outwards, your heels down. And you're gonna use the power of your back body to reach up into warrior one. So you squeeze the muscles of your back body. All right, take a deep breath in, you squeeze. And then exhale, plant your hands. Inhale, go back into plank. Exhale, lower halfway or all the way down. Inhale into upward facing dog. And then exhale into downward facing dog. And let's try that on the other side. Your left leg's gonna lift up on inhale. And exhale, draw your left foot forward. Back heel plant, so you can turn your back toes out to the side. And then use the power of your back body. As you inhale, squeeze your back body to come up to warrior one. And then exhale from there, plant your hands. Inhale back to plank. Exhale, lower halfway down or all the way down. Inhale into cobra or upward facing dog. Exhale into downward facing dog. And just two breaths here. So deep inhale, big exhale, and deep breath in. Okay, then from here, step or hop up toward the top of the mat. Once your feet land, gorilla arms, squeeze the muscles of your low back from part way up. Exhale, you re-round. You bend your knees a lot and you come into a chair pose. Take a deep breath in. Drive your feet down, and we're in mountain pose. So that was one sun salutation B, and officially it's a modified one. I'm modifying it a little bit, just for those keeping track. I know I'm a stickler about words too. So it's a modified B. You're gonna bend your knees again, arms sweep up overhead, take a huge inhale here, and then exhale you forward fold. Squeeze the muscles of your low back, look forward and maybe even up. And then exhale, plant your hands, step back or jump back into plank, lower halfway down or all the way down. Tops of feet on the floor, inhale, lift up into upward facing dog. And then from there, thighs lift you back into downward facing dog. Right leg lifts up in the air, inhale here, exhale, draw your knee in, bring the foot forward, back foot plants. Inhale, arm sweep up overhead, and then exhale, plant your hands. Inhale, back into plank. Deep inhale here. Exhale, lower halfway or all the way down. Tops of feet on the floor. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. And we'll try that with the other leg. Left leg lifts back and up. Exhale, draw your left knee in. Foot comes forward. Back foot plants. Inhale, squeeze the muscles on your back body to come upright. Exhale, plant your hands again. Inhale, back into plank position. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, lower halfway down or all the way down. Tops of feet on the floor. Inhale into cobra or upward facing dog. Exhale into downward facing dog. And like we did with the sun A's, this downward facing dog, we're going to spend a little more time here breathing a lot. So continue deep breath work. Hopefully it feels like it's a very welcome, the deep breath is very welcome because we're doing so much work right now. So it pays to take deep breaths here. Even when the pose is still, breath is dynamic. So take a deep breath in, and then exhale, step or hop up toward the front of the mat. We're Uttanasana. Inhale, squeeze the muscles on back body, look forward and maybe even up. And then exhale, you refold, and let's come into chair. So hips down, as fingers reach up, Okatasana. And then you press your feet through the ground, emerge into mountain pose. And we'll do one more sun salutation B. We're gonna add, in warrior one, we're gonna add a sort of sweeping arm work with the breath. Hopefully that feels like a good variation for your shoulders. So I will cue that when we're in warrior one. Take a deep breath in, bend your knees, Arms sweep up overhead, take a huge inhale. And then exhale, uttanasana, your forward fold. Inhale, squeeze the muscles in your low back. Look forward and maybe even up. And then exhale, plant your hands, go back in the plank, and lower halfway down or all the way down. Inhale, lift up into cobra or upward facing dog. Exhale into downward facing dog. From here, your right leg presses back and up, nice and strong. And then exhale, draw your right foot forward, back foot plants. Let's lift up into warrior one. Take a deep breath in. Arms are up. And now exhale, arms out to the side and down like you're scooping up the planet. Just draw the shoulder blades in. And then inhale, like you're lifting the planet up overhead. Huge inhale here. And then exhale, plant your hands. Inhale, back into plank. Exhale, lower halfway down or all the way down. Inhale, come into upward facing dog. Exhale into downward facing dog. And left leg lifts back and up. Take a huge inhale here. Biggest breath yet. Left foot forward. Back foot plants, heel goes down. And then reach your arms up overhead in Virabhadrasana 1, warrior 1. Now exhale, squeeze your shoulder blades in and reach your arms out and back underneath you like you're almost like you're picking yourself up. So reach up, pick it up overhead, take a huge inhale here, and then exhale, plant your hands. Inhale, go back into plank position. Exhale, lower halfway down or all the way down. Inhale into upward facing dog. Exhale into downward facing dog. And even though this pose is still, take several deep breaths. All right, and one last time, breathe in. Okay, and then step halfway or two-thirds of the way up. Inhale, squeeze muscles of low back, squeeze your shoulder blades in. Exhale, you refold and bend your knees. We come into chair pose, take a huge inhale here. Exhale, drive your feet through the floor, emerge into Tadasana. And from there, release. All right, so I hope that was fun, Sundays and Sundays. What I'd like to do is some mat strong practices. You can take a comfortable stance, and in Taiji, something like this. I'm not sure if there's like an exact where your toes need to be. I don't care, but you come with your knees bent, and so it feels like a sort of comfortable knees bent practice. This is called horse stance in Taiji. But from here, you're gonna sweep both arms overhead. Now breathe into your sides, straighten your legs. Palms come together, palms to heart center. Bend your knees now a fair amount. And you keep your knees bent. As you inhale, squeeze your shoulder blades together. Breathe into the heart center. Arch your back. And then exhale from there. Keep your knees bent as you forward fold. Round your spine. And then inhale, gorilla arms. Squeeze your shoulder blades in. Look up. Exhale, you refold. And arms sweep up overhead. Arms straighten, legs now straighten, spine long. And exhale, palms come through heart center. Bend your knees a little. Actually, not a little, a fair amount. And you come into squat. Inhale, arms sweep out to the sides. Squeeze your shoulder blades together. And then exhale, round your spine, tuck your chin. And then gorilla arms, draw your shoulder blades in. Squeeze your shoulder blades, squeeze your low back. Exhale, round again. And then inhale, come all the way up, arms straight, legs straight, spine tall, palms together, and then palms to heart center, bend your knees into squat again. Take a deep breath in, arms out to sides, squeeze your shoulder blades together, and exhale, round your spine, draw your navel and tuck your chin. Inhale, gorilla arms, squeeze your low back muscles, squeeze your shoulder blades together, exhale, refold. And then come all the way up, everything straight, legs, spine, arms, top of the inhale, palms together, palms to heart center. Let's do that one more time. Bend your knees. Inhale, you squeeze the muscles of your back body. And then exhale, round your spine, and you can tuck your chin. And then gorilla arms, low back engages, shoulder blades engage. Exhale, re-round, tuck your chin. And then inhale, come all the way up. Legs straight, arms straight. And keep your arms straight, palms relaxed. Like a wide-legged mountain pose. Okay, very good. And so take a couple breaths here. And then from here, let's come into a squat. So as I've done with other videos, you can do a fair amount of this in a chair. If you would like, you can sit on a block, and I have it at the mid-level, but you can always take it up to the top level as well, okay? So either chair, a block, or if you don't need that support, you can always just be on the ground. If your heels are up and feels like you're dangling, perhaps roll up your mat, and you can place it underneath your heels, okay? So squat, it's a great pose to master. It's nice to be in it for a while, but I like to keep on moving, perpetual motion. So palms are gonna come together, and as you inhale, you're gonna press your arms into your legs and look up. Squeeze your shoulder blades, that's your breath in, and then exhale, legs squeeze, arms, and round your spine. And let's do that 8 times total. Deep breath in as you look up. Exhale as you round. Inhale as you look up. Exhale as you round. Inhale as you look up. Exhale as you round. Inhale as you look up. Exhale as you round. And 4 more times. Take a deep breath in. Press your arms into the legs as you inhale. Legs squeeze into arms as you exhale. Inhale, legs press into, or arms press into legs. Exhale, legs press into arms. We'll do that twice more. Inhale, arms press into legs. Exhale, legs squeeze into arms. And 1 more time. Inhale, arms press into legs. Exhale, legs press into arms. And then feel a neutral spine. Take your hands onto the floor. And then as you inhale, you're gonna arch your back. So deep breath in here. I'm going to take my right arm out to the right. Exhale, you twist to the right. And then inhale, you come back to center, switch arms. Exhale, twist to the left. And we'll do this 4 times each side, 8 times total. Inhale, exhale, twist to your first side. Take a deep breath in the center. Exhale, twist to your second side. Take a deep breath in to center. Exhale, twist to your first side. Take a deep breath in the middle, lengthen spine, exhale, twist, and 2 more breaths. Inhale in the middle, exhale, twist to the first side, inhale, come to your middle, exhale, twist to your second side, and then from here, hands plant, and arch your back, look up on inhale, and exhale, and you can push your hands to the floor to assist this, but exhale, you come, keep your feet where they are, but you can come into a forward fold. Your legs don't have to be straight, and this is going to be a vinyasa, but we'll spend a couple breaths here on the first one here to just give the knees a bit of a break if you need it, and feel all the muscles in your legs. Blood comes back into your legs. All right, so from here, you're gonna come back into squat on inhale. So squat and you lift your lungs, squeeze your back body on inhale, and you round your spine, straighten your legs on exhale. Inhale, you come into squat, extension of spine. Exhale, round your spine and extend your legs. Inhale, you sit down, lungs lift. Exhale, you come out of squat. Inhale, you come into squat, arch your back. Huge exhale, round your spine, straighten your legs. Let's do that 4 more times. Inhale, have a seat, lift your lungs up. Exhale, round your spine, straighten the legs. Inhale, have a seat, lungs lift. Exhale, straighten your legs. And twice more. Inhale, have a seat, lift your lungs. Exhale, round your spine. And one last time. Inhale, lungs lift. Exhale, round your spine. From here, come all the way up to standing. Keep your feet as they are because we're gonna go into squat either a little bit, moderately, or all the way down. And And that's going to be hands-free. Arms can be out in front of you or by your sides, however you want to do that. I usually keep my hands in front of me somewhere for balance. But so inhale, I'm up. So take a deep breath in. And then exhale, you can come in the squat a little bit, moderately, all the way. Inhale, we're going to come back up. So deep breath in. So however far you go down, just know that you're coming back up. So inhale, you're up. Exhale, down. Inhale, you're up. Exhale, you're down. Even weight between feet. Your stronger leg's going to want to work more. Inhale, up. Exhale, down. Inhale, up. Exhale, down. And four more of these. Inhale, up. Exhale, down. Inhale, up. Exhale, down. And twice more. Inhale, up to standing. Exhale, down. And one last time. Breathe in. Exhale, down. Okay, so we come back up. There's eight more of those. If you're confident in your knees and your ankles, and you can try this with your feet closer together or even together, try it out, okay? If this doesn't look appealing to you, stick with what you just did eight more times, okay? So inhale, you're up. Exhale, you come down to squat. Inhale, you lift up. Exhale, you come down to squat. Inhale as you lift. Exhale, down into squat. Inhale as you come up. Exhale, down. And four more times. Breathe in. Exhale. And in breath. And exhale. Twice more. Breathe in. And big exhale. And one last time. Breathe in. And big exhale. Okay. From here, come down to seated. You actually lie on the back. All right, notice what you can notice. Done a lot of work. We're not quite done yet. Okay. But from here, so grab your block. We're gonna place the block in between your thighs, arms out to sides, and you're gonna draw your shoulder blades into the back. From here, this is a supine chair pose. So can you imagine if I was standing, I'd be in Utkatasana, supine chair pose. You're gonna squeeze the block. Inhale, you're in the middle. And then exhale, you take the block to one side. Upper body stays as still as you can. The tendency is gonna be more like roll along with it. Keep opposite shoulder down. You can roll belly opposite the block to keep your shoulder down. So inhale up to center. Exhale, as your block goes to one side, roll your navel to the other side as best you can. That will anchor your opposite shoulder. Inhale into the middle. Exhale, belly opposite block. Inhale into the middle. Exhale, belly opposite block. And go back and forth like this. You can either do this with your knees bent, or if you like an extra challenge, you can always take it with your legs straight or straighter, but I'll demonstrate straight. And then exhale, belly opposite block. Inhale, you come back up. Exhale, belly opposite block. Inhale, come back up. And go back and forth like this several more times. And do this at the pace of your breathing. Breath is leading the way. And you start off on one side. You'll finish with your other side. From there, you come back up. You can remove the block. Feet down. Release. All right. So, yeah, very good. And then from here, we're going to take the legs straight up in the air. Okay, now imagine that your legs form a pencil. The pencil tips are right at your toes. And from here, you're going to draw a circle on the ceiling. I usually take my legs away from me a little bit. That's the bottom of the circle. And as you exhale, scribe a circle from the bottom to the top. And then continue drawing that circle. Inhale to the bottom. Exhale to the top. You're engaging your abdominals a lot. Inhale to the bottom. to the bottom of the circle. And let's try this three or four more times. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. And breath. Exhale. And in breath. And exhale. And in breath. Now we're going to change the direction of the circle. Another eight. Exhale up to the top. Inhale to the bottom. Exhale to the top. Inhale to the bottom of the circle. Exhale. So yeah, deeper exhales can result in deeper inhales, can result in deeper exhales. And the breath just winds up building on itself. And let's do that two more circles. Back to center, feet can plant on the ground. All right, so pause there for a second. Move on my mat for the next, to demonstrate the next thing. All right, from here, arms by your ears, and you can draw your shoulder blades in. If it's okay for your shoulders, back of hands on the floor. If not, you can always take a goalpost position or just reach your arms up, something like this, like 45 degrees. Okay, so, both legs are up at this point. This is Supta Dandasana. All right. Bottom ribs into the ground. And first we're going to take one leg to the floor forward. So one leg is down. And then you bring the leg up. Let's switch sides. Other leg goes down to the floor. And then you bring it back up to Supta Dandasana. Inhale down. Exhale up. Inhale down. Exhale up. Let's try that four more times. Inhale down. Exhale up. Inhale down. Exhale up. Inhale down. Exhale up. And you can either do this another eight times. Inhale down. Exhale up. Or try it with two legs at the same time. Inhale down. You don't have to go all the way down if you don't want to. And then exhale, come back up. Listen to your low back and your sacrum on this one. Inhale down. You can just go down like 5 degrees and exhale, come back up. So we'll do six more of those. Inhale down. Exhale up. Inhale down. Exhale up. Inhale down. Exhale up. Inhale down. Huge exhale up. And twice more. Breathe in. Exhale. And one last time, breathe in, and exhale. All right, great. And from there, feet plant, arms relax in a comfortable place. Pause there for a moment. All right. So great, so the perpetual motion machine is slowing down. You're going to extend your left leg forward, draw right knee in, and take it over for a twist. Breathe down your right side a few times. Okay, great. And then come out of that. You can shift your hips over to the other side a little bit. Right leg extends forward, left knee in, and you take your knee over with your right hand. Breathe into your left ribs, left low back. A few times here. Come back to center, feet together, knees wide. And especially toward the end of the practice there, we did a lot of work with thighs, legs, psoas, abdomen. Feel the weight of your legs and the with all of our engagement and recruitment and strength building exercises that we've done, we can tack the other way and allow legs to relax, slow down. And also notice your breath. You don't need to breathe as quickly and perhaps as deeply, but you can still breathe just as confidently and with just as much awareness as we have been the whole practice. All right, great. And then from there, extend one leg forward, other leg forward, and pause in Shavasana. Relax down, make sure you're able to completely relax. Soften down, settle in. And you can also let go of control over your breathing. So as you let go, as you drop down, as you drop in, notice that even though you're no longer guiding your breathing and you're no longer guiding any physical practice, your body keeps going. Notice that your breath arrives moment to moment. Notice that sensations arise moment to moment. So guide your awareness to your breathing again. And very mindfully and softly harness your breath. And start taking some slightly deeper inhales. Deeper exhales. Guide a breath throughout your torso, breathe in the belly, breathe into heart. Guide a breath through your hips, down your legs, into your feet. Guide a breath through your shoulders, down your arms, into your palms. And guide a breath into your brain. And exhale down your face. All right, and then please draw one knee into your chest. Give your knee a good hug and sweep a breath across your low back. And then switch legs. Draw other knee in, sweep a breath across your low back. And then hug both knees in. Take a deep breath in. And exhale, you can roll over to one side. Notice how it feels to move again after a brief period of stillness. And then you can arrive upright to a comfortable seat. Great. So seated, notice the inward sensations. There's perpetual information. Even with little to no motion. Practice can always invite you in like this, to look inward. All right. Great. Well, thank you very much. I hope this was fun. This is a really good practice to get the joints, the guts, the muscles, just like all of our systems sort of rolling in all at once. Including the breath, which I hope was helpful and felt it felt good. So thank you so much for your practice. Namaste.